My name is Latasha Hannibal. I'm 36 years old. I'm from Philadelphia, PA, and I am a cervical cancer survivor. I started having like symptoms where I was bleeding, and I was really tired. Like I could go to sleep at 4 o'clock and sleep the whole day. And I knew that that wasn't me. So I went to the doctors and I got a doctor's appointment. And that's when I found out that, you know, I was diagnosed with cervical cancer. Well, initially it was pretty scary just to walk into the new and not knowing what's going to happen and stuff. But the doctors that I had, they were very vocal. They explained every step to me. They talked me through stuff. They gave me phone numbers for everybody so I could get in touch with them at any given time, and they were always there. So it was a lot easier to go through the experience. Well, the chemotherapy I got every other week. The radiation I got every day, except for on the weekends. Radiation wasn't as bad as chemo was. Chemo, I think, was the hardest thing. Well, I don't have any children, so it was kind of hurtful to know that I wouldn't be able to have kids. But I had my husband who was there, and so that was helpful. Fortunately, I didn't know too much about the vaccine at all. Like, you see the commercials on TV, but then you don't think that it'll happen to you until it happens to you. To grow up and, like, it just come out of nowhere, out of the blue, that's a hurtful feeling because, you know, my goal was to have children and do other things, and I can't do that now, you know, because I didn't get the vaccine. I say if you have the opportunity to do it to save your child from going through something like this, then go ahead. The only thing that I knew about it was the things that I saw on commercials. Like, I had never knew in depth on what it could cause. I never knew how important it was to have it. And even when I got diagnosed with cancer, I didn't even know where it came from, you know, until now. You know, so I didn't know that it was that important. I don't think that growing up, my family talked about it at all. I didn't know anything. I was oblivious to it, actually. Make sure that you get those appointments, because I think that probably was my issue, because I didn't go to the doctors as much as I should have. Just, you don't really take it into consideration as much as how important those doctor visits are. And so I say, make sure that you get them done every year. You know, people in my area, they don't really take going to the doctors as serious as possible until they get sick. So I say, don't wait until you're sick or something's wrong with you. Make sure that you go. Make sure that you keep the doctor's appointments every 6 months, every year. Just stay up on that kind of stuff. Get it done. Talk to your doctor, see what works for you, and save yourself in the long run.